Hey YouTube, Coppersan here. If you would have asked me to make this video a year ago, I would have probably laughed at you because I never touched those bosses back then. But hey, here we are 1 year further and all these MapleStory bosses are a piece of cake. In today's video, I'll be explaining how you can fight Chaos Akum, the Chaos Root Abyss bosses and Harp Magnus. And then in the next video that will be out relatively soon, I'll go over Princess No, Chaos Papulatus, Normal Lotus and Normal Damien. There are timestamps throughout the video for every single boss. We're starting off with the 8-armed Statue of Slabs, a Chaos Akum. When you're able to start this boss fight depends a lot on your class and your stats. My Demon Slayer, for example, could first beat this boss with around 5k main stats, 85% IED and 105% boss damage. IED is ignore enemy defense, very important boss stat. And my Wind Archer could beat this boss around 4k stats with 75% IED and 181% boss damage. The best way to figure out if you're ready to fight these bosses is to just try. You can always go into practice mode. During the first phase of this fight, Zakum will attempt to squish your character like a bug by raising his hands and slapping down. Look out for the indicators on the ground and move out of the way. If you are in a bad spot, a skill that gives an invincibility frame can be used as well to dodge the attack. Just make sure you time it right when the arms are coming down. Or if your class has an upwards jump, you can also jump up in the air to avoid the attack completely and just fly away like a wind archer. During the fight, I always focus on one side of Zakum. If you destroy the arms, Zakum will stop smashing them down because there are no more arms. So if you take down all the arms on one side, it will make your life so much easier. You'll have a lot of safe spots that you can move around in. Once the arms respawn, I usually move to the other side to destroy the already weakened arms and then just repeat. So go left, go right, defeat the arms, wait for the arms to respawn, go back to the other side, etc, etc. At one point, Zakum will also start the Floor is Lava minigame where you have to stand on platforms to avoid continuous damage. Zakum will clap his hands together, one-shotting anyone who stands on one of the three platforms. Where this attack is going to hit on which platform is shown by an indicator, giving you a few seconds to react. Destroying the arms on the one side will stop Zakum from smashing them together, so for example if you defeat the bottom two arms on the left, the bottom platform will be safe until you respawn. If you're having trouble with phase 1 because you keep dying when you respawn, like my fiance Femke had a lot, she would respawn, Zakum would instantly slam down on her, she died right away, hated it. The resistance link skill could be of help if you're having the same issue. This skill makes you invincible for a few seconds when you respawn, which will help a ton with this boss, and will give you some time to get your buffs up if you're not using buff freezers. Also, when you defeat all arms too fast, Zakum will go into an enrage mode, preventing you from dealing damage for a while. He'll start summoning mobs and does a full screen attack that will deal 99% damage. This phase sucks, so I would just take it easy if you are strong enough to defeat all the arms before Zakum drops to about 20% HP. Just keep fighting one side of Zakum without destroying all the arms. That way you can skip this phase and just go to the final phase without any issues. The final phase has stuff falling from the ceiling that slows your character and prevents you from jumping away or using mobility skills for a few seconds. So try to avoid those, because Zakum will jump and slam down, instantly killing anyone who is not in a green cube that spawns just a few seconds before Zakum lands. You can bind Zakum to prevent the attacks for a little bit, and like always, invincibility frames help as well. So make sure to be in that green cube as soon as it spawns, be careful of the falling debris, and just keep hitting Zakum until he dies, and that should be enough to get you through this fight actually. Next up is the Chaos Chicken Von Bon. This boss can require anywhere between 6 and 10k main stat and around 85% IED depending on your class. A little bit less if you want to struggle a bit more, a little bit more if you want to have an easier time. This boss can be unlocked after clearing the related Root Abyss questline and defeating the normal version 5 times. This goes for all Root Abyss bosses. Before you can fry this chicken, make sure to lower your skill transparency, because the hardest part of this boss fight is actually seeing what the hell that chicken is doing. Chaos Von Bon spawns clocks on the map. The light clocks will speed up the timer if Von Bon stands on them, and the dark clocks will increase the timer. So unless you can burst him down, you want Von Bon to stand in dark clocks as much as possible. This boss teleports and moves around, so try to lure him to a right spot. Also, be careful that you don't bind the boss in the wrong clock, or that little maneuver is gonna cost you like all 10 minutes of your fight. Von Bon also shoots an orb that will one-shot you, but you can either dodge that by jumping over it or ducking. Invincibility frames of course work as well. After you drop Von Bon to about 80% of his health, he gets another attack to spice up his arsenal. Thankfully, the spice ends mostly there, unlike the 11 spices and herbs from the actual KFC. This chicken isn't seasoned that well. Von Bon jumps in the air and slams down, and everyone who's still on the ground will die the moment he slams down. So jump style is not dead yet when fighting this boss. Those mush bomb mechanics are still going strong in MapleStory. One tip I can give you is to play with your sound on, as Von Bon has a sound cue every time he does that jump attack. Von Bon will always jump attack after shooting two killer orbs, so count those, and avoiding the jumps should be a bit easier because you'll know when it's coming. Every now and then, Von Bon will also create a shadow of your character, and after a few seconds, your character gets teleported it back to the location of the shadow. Make sure to lure Von Bonn away to prevent any unfortunate work accidents while you get teleported back to your previous location. Keep lowering his HP while keeping the clocks in mind, and once Von Bonn gets a bit lower, he will retreat into a different dimension. Follow him there and defeat his clone to get back to the normal world. You'll take continuous damage in that dimension, so be careful, he can also seal you in there. Once you reach the end of the fight, Von Bonn will unlock his final attack, his final spice. He teleports away and spreads his wings, pushing anyone who is too close backwards. Also, stuff will fall from the sky. Avoid that at all costs, because those bigger ones can deal a lot of damage. I hope you don't think this mode is too bad, because just wait until we get to Hard Magnus at the end of this video. Just avoid him when he teleports and don't get too close when you're fighting and you should be fine. Next up is the Chaos Crimson Queen, which besides Von Bonn is one of the easier bosses of Chaos Root Abyss. Similar to the Chicken, I recommend anywhere between 6 to 10k main stat and around 85% IND to challenge this boss. Also, do keep in mind that some classes need a bit more funding and some classes need a bit less, like my Shade was really struggling while my Demon Slayer was having a way easier time. The Queen is basically 4 monsters in one. She swaps faces and with that also attack patterns. This is her normal face, her resting face I guess. When she's wearing this face, okay that's a weird sentence, the Queen's claw attack will blind you. She will also have a purple breath attack, which can easily be avoided by simply standing behind her when you see her charging it up, or just move far away enough so you don't get hit. She will also cast an aura in this mode that deals damage over time, which can be very annoying. This aura stacks as well, so be very careful, this can be very dangerous. Then there is her winking face. Her normal attacks seal, and she summons a mirror that will seduce you. Guess your own character is just too hot to resist, huh? Break the mirror as soon as you see it, else you will die. And she will also spawn hearts that will deal around 50% of your HP as damage per heart, so don't go jumping into those. Once she switches to her smiling face, be careful of her sucking attack. This one will really suck the life out of you. If you touch the Queen while she's performing the big suck, you will die, so you're better off avoiding that completely by either standing behind her or by again moving far enough away from her. And her most dangerous face is her bleeding tears face. The Queen will cause damage deflection and zombify. And while damage deflection isn't that bad, if you are zombified, if you use potions, you will take damage instead of healing, which can be very deadly in combination with her damage over time aura. So be very careful of the zombify icon. When fighting the Queen, you want to avoid the claw swipes and status effects that it brings with it. Make sure to break the mirror as soon as you see it and be careful of her zombify status. Every face of the Queen is also a different monster, so you can bind every single face if you want to, unlike the regular 90 second cooldown time on a bind. And it's even more awesome if you're playing a class like Shade that can reset their binds, or if you're in a party with classes with multiple binds, make sure to use all of those. Don't stick too close to her and just make sure to avoid her attacks. It will take some practice, but hey, you got this. The worst out of all bosses in Chaos Root Abyss is this stupid clown. This fight is no joke, and I would rather fight 3 Chaos Vellums at the same time than 1 Chaos Pierre. Pierre can wear one of 3 hats, which switches every 30 seconds once his health drops below 70%. In purple mode, he just walks and pushes you around with his umbrella. Be careful of the hats falling down, that will lock you in place until you break free from them, and if you're not fast enough, you will actually die from them as well. Once he wears a red hat, he will teleport away and appear again at the location of either yourself or a party member, unleashing a one-shot attack. Avoid this by just moving away to a different spot, and also keep in mind where your party members are if you are going in a party. When he wears the blue hat, he'll start spinning around. The fire will deal some minor continuous damage over time, and touching Pierre will seal you, so be careful of that. When fighting Pierre, your character will also get a random hat assigned to them as well. If you're for example wearing a red hat and Pierre is wearing a blue hat, you'll deal double the damage to him, and of course the other way around as well. If you're wearing the same hat as him, you'll heal him instead of dealing damage, and if he's wearing the purple hat and you're wearing a red or blue hat, you'll just deal normal damage to him. Dying will remove your hat though, so keep it in mind. Pierre's fight is pretty okay until his HP drops below 30%, which is around this point. Then the worst boss mechanic ever invented in MapleStory will happen. Pierre will split, creating 2 bodies who will always have different hats and need to be defeated within 5 seconds of one another to keep them from respawning, which is pretty epic stuff. So ideally what you want to do if you're soloing Pierre is wait for his HP to hit around this spot and then wait until you get a hat of the opposite color. So either when Pierre is red and you're blue, or the other way around. Yeah, that way you'll deal double the damage to him, which will make bursting him a lot easier. Bind him if you can and burst him down before he has a chance to split. This is easier said than done and will take a lot of practice though. If you cannot do this, you'll have to defeat both Pierres at the same time, which is super difficult and annoying. You can die to make sure you don't have a hat and try bursting down both of the clowns at the same time, but mess it up and the one looking like a clown will be you instead. The final boss of Root Abyss is Vellum. Velim is a lot tougher than the other three Rudabis bosses, and I recommend getting at least around 10k of your main set if you don't want to struggle too much, and anywhere between 85 and 94% IAD. If you are struggling to get up IAD, try getting the Luminous, Zero, Hoyoung, or Explorer Mage Link skill, and Familiars can give IAD as well, which could be nice to boost your IAD a little bit. Velim will use Dig to go underground and you won't be able to hit him. Then the next turn he pops out and deals a ton of damage. Depending on if his full body is out or only halfway through, you'll either die instantly or you'll take a good chunk of damage. You don't know if he's going to come out fully or not, just try to avoid that at all costs. During this fight, Tails will pop out as well that will one-shot you, so also avoid those. And to make things even more difficult, there also are rocks falling down from the ceiling that will stun you for a couple of seconds if they hit, which can be very deadly. Get hit by a rock, get hit by a tail, and it's bye-bye one life. Velim has a few attacks he can unleash. There is a fireball attack that will instantly kill you. Move behind the boss this time to avoid the attacks. This is also a great opportunity to deal damage to him, as he will remain stationary for a while. Just be careful of the tails. If you can't stay in one spot for a little while, you can try stacking the tails a bit to make it easier to dodge them. Velim will also dig around underground and dive back up over a larger area. Avoid this attack at all costs as well, because it will kill you, but you can hit Velim during his dive, so you can at least get a little bit of damage in. Once his HP drops to about 60%, Velim will start using his green lightning attack. This attack doesn't kill you right away, but deals around 70% of your HP as damage if you get hit by the lightning, and it leaves an area on the ground that deals damage over time. Again, Velim is standing still this time, which is a great opportunity to deal some damage, but try to dodge the lightning as you could die from that if your HP is low. Also pay very close attention to the tails, because the indicators are a bit more difficult to see with all the green stuff on the ground. Velim also has this fun attack, where he shoots a massive laser throughout the map that will suck you in and one-shot you. You'll see a message appearing on the top of your screen that will tell you that's gonna happen. Jump to either one of the sides where you see Velim charging up his laser and stand behind him. This can be tricky for lower mobility classes, so try fighting Velim close to the center to have more time to check which side he's on, and be super careful of the debris falling down as it will spell instant death. Pick your moments when you are bursting and keep in mind that damaging the tails that pop up won't actually do anything to the health bar. Also keep your positioning in mind when fighting this boss and try to lure either the boss or the tails in spots that are favorable for you. The final boss of this video is Heart Magnus. Heart Magnus is a death simulator. This boss isn't about surviving as much as it is about positioning. Everything in this boss fight will kill you, from the endless amount of blue balls and purple balls falling down to every single attack Magnus throws at you. The only thing that doesn't kill you is his dash and his super pushback, but that's bound to knock you into some unwanted debris that will kill you if you don't have like super stance. Magnus has a few insta-death attacks. If he shoots up in the sky and holds his wings like he's charging up some laser, that's because that's exactly what he's doing. Stand right under him and you're good. You can deal damage this time as well. If he flies upwards with his sword pointing down, do not stand below him. If you get hit by that attack, you will get killed. And his most annoying attack is this one. He summons multiple spots on the map that will hit after a short delay, killing everyone who stands inside of those marked yellow areas. Moving around ain't no easy task either. Besides the constant debris falling down, if you are outside the blue zone around Magnus, you will take continuous damage. Your own damage against Magnus is reduced, and healing is reduced as well. If you are outside of the zone for too long, you will die. So sticking close to Magnus is a must, but that isn't an easy task exactly. To make things worse, there is gas. Lots of gas. On the left and right edges of the map, every now and then, gas will spawn, which will stun you for a longer period of time. Get gassed and you're as dead as can be. This is super troublesome, because if you die, you'll always respawn at the left side of the map where the gas is. If Magnus dashes towards you and sticks around in that area, it can be very deadly. If I'm stuck in a loop like that, what I usually do is I make a mad dash for the center and then die there so Magnus will dash towards my floating dead body. Fighting Heart Magnus is a battle of perseverance. Don't be afraid to die out a couple of times to make sure Magnus is in the right spot. Try to keep fighting in the middle as much as you can so you can avoid the gas. The safe, and I put safe in quotation marks, area around Magnus gets smaller as well as you deplete his health bar, and more stuff will start falling from the sky as the battle goes on. Time your invincibility frames well and save up your bind for the last part of the fight, or stay dead until your bind and iframes are back up again and the boss can be bound again. Keep in mind that binds only work on bosses every 90 seconds. Getting Magnus' health down to zero can be pretty tough towards the end, so save your bind and burst to skip that that part, or you can expect to die out a lot of times. And those were the first 6 bosses of this mini-series. I will get to work on the next part featuring Normal Lotus, Normal Damien, Chaos Pepperlattice, Princess No, and more right away. I hope this video was useful to you, and as always, many thanks to our members for making this video possible. Many thanks to Niels de Konnik, Rama Waar, Sebastian Hanoi, FLX, Riley Oz, Terry Kim, Varese, Saudi Mora, Wiley, Francisco Sousa, History Cannon, Backspace, OTI, Sophronix, Lonzo, BG Extremes, Anwar NHI, Frank Bouguet, Zeedier, Flidiot, BeamerWT, Knifesu, Chen125, Cloudfix, Gusus Rodriguez, Froggy11, Sir Tito655, Glason, Brandon Cam, Vira, Trevor, Michael Machaca, Ratius, Lucky Beats, Justin Vale, Silvio Nato, Stevie Zhang, Afterlord underscore MS, Heopan, Simak, Joshua Alvarez, Striker Elk, Nok MSS, Niu, Tide1 Pan, Victor Sundstrom, Radicals the Alien, Stanislaus Kosumo Begus, Riser Are You, Eddie Reacts to Things, Dular, Gummy Bullet, Leon Reddle, Booty Warrior GT, Jeremy Sotler, Mr. Anark, Lovebird, Rev Soli, Yeruski TV, Yo Mama, Matthias Simonson, Caveman, oh yeah, and Galando Blavia. Thank you all so much for watching. Stay safe and happy mapling.